Hello guys, here is Rob from P-Hanger. Today I want to talk about hanging the Mecca of penis enlargement. Why is it so? Probably you're asking yourself, who is this guy and what he's talking about? Well, my name is Rob and I'm hitting the gym since I'm 13 years old. Once in a while, after a few years, I ask myself if there's something also to improve penis length. Not that I had any problems with it. I was even at a higher average scale once I started. And it was just something what I was curious about, and after a while I experienced the pleasure with having a bigger dick and everything what comes with it. And there's so many marketing scam outside and so many people who are talking about this and that I just want to share with you my experience, what I had. I mean, it's like when you are going to the gym and a personal trainer comes to you with zero muscles and want to explain you how to add muscles. I mean, it's something, it doesn't work. What does work is hanging. Hanging is the most effective way for penis enlargement. Why is it so? The first and most important point is the most effective way to stretch the legs is by using a hanger. When you sit on a chair, hanging straight down from a chair, this means you will attach the ligamentum suspensory. You can palpate them with two fingers, so you can see how far attached is it. In the previous, before you started hanging, how far attached the ligament is to your pelvic bone, and there you can see the inner circle of your dick. So this means your package will come lower, and the inner part of the dick will come outside. And this is all achieved by hanging straight down from a chair. And this is something what you will not reach with, for example, manual stretches or other exercises, because before you will change anything inside your body, you will just get a tennis elbow or something, because it's too much work, too much force what you need to do manually to achieve anything. Yes, you will achieve maybe a few bit here and there, some kind of newbie gains, but nothing substantial. And this is the difference. You need to do it with a method and not only by following a simple routine after your bath or anything else for 10 minutes or so. This just won't work. But also, we also won't make a Ferrari out of a Fiat. So yeah, you can just talk to me and write me a mail, and we can talk about your personal constellation and what's the best way for you. And the second most important improvement advantage of hanging is that it stretches the skin. For example, other extender or hangers, which are vacuum hangers, they are attached to the glands. And with this method, you won't stretch the skin. And what we need here is, if you don't stretch the skin, you will always have the ligamentum will always retract and again attach to the pelvic bone, and we want to have it completely loose. And in order to get this loose and get your package lower, we also need to stretch skin, and the skin is automatically stretched when you hang from a chair down. So this is something what will take time. Sometimes you will stretch the ligamentum and sometimes you will stretch the skin. It depends what comes first, you know. Where you make more progress, then the other one will always lag behind it. You will start about 1 kilogram and you increase the weight weekly by 10%. This means most of my gains I achieved about 4 to 7 kilograms. But it's a long way. Up to then you will reach always plateaus which you need to attack and find new ways. But hanging on a chair straight down, in my case it took 2 years to get the ligamentum completely stretched. It can be done faster, it can be done in more time. It depends on your genetics, also on your age, if you smoke, if you have a calorie deficit or not, what type of guy you are, and how hard your tissues are. And this also depends much on your age. In general, the golden rules is, I mean, we hang 1.5 hours per day, and it's very important that we don't have rest days. I mean, rest days are not good, because the ligamentum will then heal and reattach to the pubic bone. I mean, this won't happen in one day. If you have one day where you need to go here or there, it's fine. One day isn't that bad, but in general, no rest days. If you experience fatigue or shrinkage, after all, then just reduce the weight, but don't do rest days. And this let me come to the second point, make a healthy ritual out of it. This means when you are working 8 hours or 9 hours a day, if you have kids, if you have a wife, don't say you have no time and do this thing, because this will make you mentally ill. I mean, if you take it as priority number one in your life, then you have a problem. We do this here for fun, because we love to go to the gym and see the new body and so. This is something that shouldn't be prioritized in your life. However, you need the consistency, and you also need to make it a ritual. What I mean by that is that you need to make circumstances in your environment that you can do it. I mean, if you study, for example, I started this when I studied and I had a lot of time. I was hanging and I was able to learn while doing it, and I need to learn anyway. So with that, it was easy for me. I hanged about two and a half years straight down every day. And I gained about 2.5 inches in length, and also about 2 inches in girth. Because my inner part of the dick was much larger or thicker than this part. So I was lucky there. Maybe it was also just from hanging, I don't know. However, it was a big pleasure for us, let me say. Then the next thing is right, the fatigue. The fatigue is when you feel the stretch here in the ligamentum. This means you feel some kind of burning or fire, and after that also a shrinkage of the penis you experience. This is because the tissue is working and your body is changing. This isn't something bad, but you can also experience a loss in EQ, which means erection quality. But this will come again. This is not forever. You go down with the weight, you just go further and further, and this will go away. And it's a good sign. And that's why I say right the fatigue. It's something important. You can improve it a little bit by, if you take, for example, arginine or other ingredients which improve the blood flow down there. We have the P-Hanger recovery volume pills, for example. You can use them. It's not necessary, but I used it. That's it after all. Let me know if you have any questions, if you have something what you want to talk about in the next videos, if there is something what I should explain more in detail, or you can also just let me know what's your experience with it. I mean, there are a lot of people outside and everyone has a meaning about it. However, I dedicated all in all 5 years of my life to it, which doesn't mean that I did it the whole day for 5 years, but I also lost a lot of time by listening and choosing methods which are not sustainable. They just can't work. And it's like, when we go to the gym, we have so many experienced plans and routines that we know that they are working. And even there, the people are not eating enough or not training heavy enough, and it's very difficult. And in this matter of penis enlargement, we have so much more peoples and things which are going around, which are just not proven. I mean, even my method isn't proven. But in a surgery, for example, in a penis enlargement surgery, what is done is they cut the ligamentum and then the penis comes outwards and hangs lower. And after that, they also need to use an extender so that the other ligaments don't attach again. So it's something what's logically what we do here and why we do it. However, it's very difficult to understand for people who are interested in this topic to find the right explanation, the right routine. And like I said, I dedicated 5 years of my life to it. I have a lot of experience in that terms. And if I can help you, you're welcome.